unrequited, robs me of my rest. Love, hopeless love, my heart and soul encumbers.
Love, nightmare-like,
lies heavy on me chest. And weaves itself into my midnight slumbers.
When you're lying awake with a dismal headache, your repose is to boot by anxiety. I conceive you may use any language you choose to indulge in without impropriety. For your brain is on fire, the bedclothes conspire of usual slumber to plunder you. First your counterpane goes and uncovers your toes, and your sheet slips demurely from under you. The blanketing tickles, you feel like mixed pickles, so terribly sharp is the pricking. And your heart and your cross and your tumble and toss till there's nothing twixt you and the ticking. Then the bedclothes will creep into the ground in a heap, and you pick them all up in a tangle. Next your pillow resigns and politely declines to remain at its usual angle. Will you get some repose in the form of a doze with hard eyeballs and head ever aching? But your slumbering teens with such horrible dreams that you'd very much better be waking. For you feel you are crossing the channel and tossing about in a steamer from Greenwich, which is something between a large bathing machine and a very small second-class carriage. And you're giving a treat penny, ice and cold meat to a party of friends and relations. But a ravenous horde, and they all came on board at Sloane Square and South Kensington stations. And bound on that journey, you find your attorney who started that morning from Devon. He's a bit undersized, and you don't feel surprised when he tells you he's only 11. Well, you're riding like mad with the singular lad. By the pie, the ship's now a four-wheeler. And you're playing our games, and he calls you bad names, and you tell him the ties by the dealer. Well, this you can't stand, so you throw up your hands, and you find it as cold as an icicle. And your shirt and your socks and black silk with gold gosh crossing stars, but he played on a bicycle. And he and the crew are on bicycles too, which they've somehow or other invested in. And he's telling the tars all the particulars of a company he's interested in. It's a scheme of devices to get at low prices, or goods from cloth mixtures to cables, which tickled the sailors by treating retailers as though they were all vegetables. You get a good spaceman to plant a small tradesman, first take off his boots with a boot tree, and his legs will take root and his fingers will shoot till they blossom in but like a fruit tree. From the green grocer tree you get grape and green pea, cauliflower, pineapples and cranberry, while the pastry cook plant cherry patties for granddad. Puffs and three corners and bamberries. The shares of a penny and ever so many are taken by Rothschild and Banning. And just as a few were allotted to you, you awake with a shudder despairing. You're a regular wreck with a crick in your neck and no one ear snuggles. Your head's on the floor and your needles and pins from your soles to your shins and your fletches are creaking because your left leg just sleeps as a cramp and your tail's in a fly and your nose is a puff and you're not gonna be with a stag and a thirst. It's a dent in the general sense that you haven't been sleeping in clover. But the darkness has passed and it's daylight at last and the night has been long. Ditto, ditto, my song. And thank goodness they're both of them.